It was very nice, you know, but the days were quite long, weren't they?
Yeah. They were, but fun.
No, it was great. In fact, we've signed up, well, we're for Queen.
Sorry,
am I speaking out turn?
I don't know.
No, I don't know. But I think
what was it like for both of you to get back into those characters in Big Finish?
Well, it was just nice to see each other again, and Gemma and Jamie.
Yeah.
I think we slipped back into it quite easily, didn't we, really?
Definitely. It was like visiting an old friend, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It just kind of came naturally. And especially when everyone was together, it just felt like the family was reunited. Yeah, it was really nice.
Yeah. We were quickly back into insulting each other.
Yeah, all the time.
The mutual disrespect, you know.
It's called banter, David.
Banter, bad enough.
Banter.
But before we did them, I assumed that they were old episodes that they'd unearthed, and then I got there and realised that they were all newly written. But they were so well written.
Yeah.
They were like in the style of that time, and they captured that era.
Yeah,
and I thought they were really good, but we did a lot of episodes, you know.
A lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, in a short space of time.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So it was fun. Yeah. There wasn't any pressure to feel like I was playing the Doctor in Adventure in Space and Time, because I was playing, but the responsibility and the pressure came from portraying William Hartnell accurately, and because his granddaughter Jessica, who wrote a book called Who's There, I think it was, and so she gave me a copy of that, so that filled me in on a lot of his history, and of course having the benefits that we all had of seeing the original old black and white footage in order to play them, but the responsibility was in doing justice to someone who was a fine actor, one of the best British character actors of his time, but also the fact that he was a very very complicated man, and he had, you know, he had a few problems, and Mark Gatiss thankfully made him a completely rounded human being for all his virtues and his darker side, and so you felt it was an honest portrayal rather than just a kind of soft focused biopic, and so it felt coming back to it for the Christmas special, I thought, wow, this is like not an actor playing the actor who played Doctor Who. This is playing Doctor Who. And so I wouldn't say it was a pressure, because I'd had the background of playing in Adventure, and so all that kind of fed into it and helped. I think I would have found it difficult just playing the Doctor in the Christmas special without having done Adventure in Space and Time, which one of the best, if not the best experience I've ever had, really, because we did it in the conditions that they did it, more or less, didn't we, in a very short space of time.
Yeah, and it was just super fun.
Yeah, and it wasn't like any pressure to... you said we had fun along the way, and we got it done within the time. Mind you, now it's easier nowadays for actors to work on TV than it was in Hartnell's time, because, as you probably know, they had no time for retakes or anything, and they had to negotiate those massive cameras and all those cables on the floor. And now we can just stop and say, sorry, can I pick it up from the previous line, because I messed up. But
it's more like a play then, wasn't it? More
yes.
Like doing
it,
yeah.
Yes. And I should imagine the pressure of doing that, working in that way in the early 60s, must have been enormous. Yeah. Well, with Jodie, because we did, our paths didn't cross on the Christmas special, of course, but it did in Broadchurch, and I, as soon as I heard that she was doing it, I was really very surprised, but happily surprised, because I know that she's got this great depth as an actress, and but anyone who saw Broadchurch saw the range she had, and not only that, just hanging out with her, you realise what fun she is, and she's always, you know, up for a laugh. So she's got everything needed for playing the part. I think she'd be absolutely brilliant. So I was very excited when I saw she was doing it. Peter was an absolute joy right from the word go, because I'd never worked with him before, but I'd met him briefly when he came to the set of Adventure in Space and Time.
Yeah,
you remember?
We didn't know that he was the Doctor then.
No, right? No. And he said he didn't either, but he...
he's a big fan, wasn't he?
He was a big fan, yes, and I think a friend of Mark's, so he just came in, and I think it was a while after that he just found out himself, so he said that he got the part. But it was... when someone's been playing something, such an iconic character, for so long, you just don't know when someone has kind of ownership of the part for that long, and you just come in right at the end to share the screen with him, and what was a great, great story that they came up with, and I was so thrilled. I just said, as soon as they asked me to do it, I didn't read a script or anything. I just said, yes, please. and he was an absolute joy. We had a lot of laughs. And we're not of the same age. I'm a slightly more senior in terms of years. But we share a lot of territory in terms of people we've worked with and people we know and things that we've been involved in. So we, he was just great fun, and we just, in between takes, we just never stopped talking. And when I had guests visiting the set, he was just so, he took so much care and attention that to make sure that they had a good time. You know, some of my family and friends visited, and he would, you know, he had quite a lot on his plate to learn, and but he would say, "Come and show me, let me meet your friends," and he chatted to them and did little sketches for them and said, "Have you seen the TARDIS? Have you seen my TARDIS?" And he just conducted a little tour, and when he should have been resting up, you know, and he was an absolute gent. So, and I hope that's not the last time I'll work with him. So. It was fun because it's like these two different generations, and Hartnell's Doctor came from a time which wasn't so, let's say, PC, and he comes in and he brings all that 1960s. Gentle chauvinism, you know, where they, you know, he'll say to when Pearl Mackey came back, you know, and her character, and she says, "Oh, I've missed you. I've missed you so much." So her and Peter's Doctor reunited, and my Doctor says, "Well, my dear, I think he's missed you too. This spaceship is getting a little bit dusty. It just needs a bit of a spring clean." and Peter's 12th doctor, she said, no, you can't say that. Why not, you know. And he comes from that kind of era way, you know. And there are a few little clashes, you know, in terms of this thing that pop up now and again during the show, which make you realise there's quite a those 50 years make, you know, quite a difference in attitudes, and because he's from that time and he's bringing all this into the scenes, and so it doesn't provide a big conflict, but just a difference of ideas, and I hope it's as funny as it looked on paper.
Did you get to spend any time with Caroline Ford when you were researching the
part? I had, before we started filming, I had a really long telephone conversation with her, where she just told me everything that she could possibly tell me. She's a really lovely, lovely woman. And then she visited the set a couple of times, I think.
Yeah.
To kind of see what was going on, if I had any other questions for her. So I got to chat to her quite a bit, which was really helpful, yeah.
Working with Matt Smith's Doctor as well on Dinosaurs on a Spaceship. I really enjoyed you in that as well.
Yeah. Well, I thought, I went into the studio on my first day on that, and there was this old TARDIS in the corner in the dark, and I thought, that's it. So I had to go over and touch it and open the door and everything. And I thought that was going to be my Doctor Who experience, and little did I know that something else was lurking around the corner. So... But he was great fun. In fact, we flew out to it was San Diego together for the big Comic Con there, and we were walking through the forecourt of the airport together at Heathrow, and there was a big display and a stand with a big picture of Matt more than life size. And they were promoting the show, and we were walking through the concourse on the way to the gate, and he said, just a minute. And he walked over and he said, what's going on here then?
Yeah.
And I said, oh, it's a Doctor Who thing that we're doing, and I hope you like it and everything. And nobody clocked him. He'd had a bit of a haircut for some other TV he'd done. But amazing, he was chatting to these people for quite a few minutes, and nobody clicked that he was...
willing to come back to the TV series as the First Doctor at some point in the future if they asked you?
Oh, if they asked me, yes. I'd bite their hand off. I think it would be fun, yes. But so far, I'm very happy to be being involved in both things, as well as the Dinosaurs, of course. But it's quite something you never expect in your career, something that you've watched when you were young and just never imagined you'd be involved in something so iconic. It's just let's say it's a late treat. if someone wanted to do that, I'd be very interested. Yeah, of course.
Have you got your eyes set on Star Wars? Just
well, that would be nice, but I don't know. I don't know what I could do in that. I saw the last one and loved it, but wouldn't it be nice? Yeah, that'd be like a full house at poker, wouldn't it? A complete running flush.